Return the map. It will bring you great danger. Stop now.
I don't usually leave the asylum in the middle of the night, but he said you'd make it worth my while. I'm listening. So you want me to throw her father into the asylum unless she agrees to marry you? Oh, that is despicable. I love it.
Speak! Speak! Answer the charges against you! Say something! Bring in another witness. Well, what say you to that? I have one more question which I know you must answer. Are you Christ, the Son of the Blessed One?
Of course. Those mutant turtles must have figured out that the crystal has the power to stabilize their mutations. With even the tiniest piece, I can genetically recreate another crystal. Then I can complete the Vortex Transporter. I'm sending you on a mission, Hightech. You'll orbit the galaxy like a space probe and return with untold data in, say, 2,000 light years. The transformation is complete. Alex Winter is no more. And now there is only Mega Balls. Now I can create charged matter on a vast scale, including a new suit of armor.
A perfect pilot must handle any situation. You told me your tin men were perfect.
But what do you want me to do?
I suggest you call for help. Arbalu, we've hit a bit of a snag with the professor's contraption. Any suggestion?
You've disappointed me, Professor. Worse, you have deceived me. But I have a solution.
You do?
You give me back all my money, and I'll give you back all your cretinous contraptions.
You seem surprised to see me, man cub. I can't imagine why. I wasn't going to let you get away with what you did to me. You see, you humiliated me, man cub. Surely you do realize I simply can't let you live.
Why does everyone hate me so? Why does everyone try to run from me or try to bribe me? Don't people know how that makes me feel?
We brought you here to decide your fate, to be tried for your crimes. We are all creatures of the same earth, and these 12 angry animals are some of the most persecuted. Thanks. Humans like you.
Just pray the police find her, Pristine, or we're doomed to return to the ranks of the peasantry. And you'd better hope this rumor that Dashing Daddy Starling may have survived the avalanche is just a rumor. Or we'll be worse than ordinary. We'll be...
Don't say it!
Poor.
Penniless.
Bankrupt.
No more money.
We've got to have money.
Finally, someone worthy of my magic has released me. What is it that you seek?
Oh, not much, really. Just
all of your secrets.
Ah, a wizard with a taste for power. I like that. The key to all of the magical secrets in the cosmos is held within the Philosopher's Stone.
Yes, where can I find this stone?
You do not find it. You make it.
We don't know where she's from or how she came to be.
But happy was the day she came.
Can you do nothing for yourself? In the Tomb of Riches resides the magic lamp.
Tomb of Riches?
Of course you don't know. Its location is revealed every 3 years by the light of a full blue moon.
Whoever possesses the lamp controls the power of the genie within.
You've come to Paris in her darkest hour, Captain. It will take a firm hand to save the weak-minded from being so easily misled.
Misled, sir?
Look, Captain. Gypsies. The gypsies live outside the normal order. Their heathen ways inflame the people's lowest instincts, and they must be stopped.
You must be the foreigner the Wazir warned me about. I've standing orders to kill you on sight. I'll give you 5 seconds to explain what you're doing here. I warn you, it had better be good. What touch has awakened my sleep? I smell the blood of a mortal. Reach out thine hand again, fleshy human, that I might devour it. It has been centuries since I last ate. Light, darkness. The two sides of existence locked in an eternal struggle for the hearts and minds of the living. Each side claims its share. But what of those caught in between? Which way will they turn? Welcome, dreamers. I am the magical wishing starfish. You have braved many dangers to find me. Enter the Forbidden Zone. Go alone. For only your metallic heart is evil enough to withstand the dangers. You have been warned.
Congratulations, Secret. Another case brilliantly solved. One small matter still puzzles me, though. Whatever did you do with all those gold teeth?
At last, the mighty one. Ah, I see you received my package as prophesied 5,000 years ago. Do help him up, Norman. After all, you are the guardian of the mighty one.
You, my little mixed-breed friend, have recently been rummaging in a pile of garbage in back of a butcher shop.
Big deal. I could have told you that.
You also spent a goodly portion of the morning chewing a 3-day-old ham bone. And if my nose is correct, as it usually is, it was a rather inferior cut of meat.
So what's wrong with a little rump roast?
You came here via the bakery, but you didn't stop to dig in their garbage because you ran into a long-legged female Afghan.
I haven't always had friends like you, because I was born different. Because I didn't fit in, society shunned me. All my life, the world has tried to forget my face. But after tonight, they will never forget my name. Professor Chrome Dome, prepare to fire!
And you, my once and former herald, I hereby exile you to the planet you have saved. No longer shall you soar the endless skyways for the rest of your days. I condemn you to this minor galaxy. Meet your end, my friend. Telex serves.
Mary Jane arrived here seeking the truth about her father. She has found it and found him.
Why would you deny her such fulfillment? Isn't that what we're all longing for? After all, isn't there someone with whom you want to be reunited? Ah, yes. Of course there is.
On the contrary, death is the ultimate fairness. Rich and poor, young and old, all are equal in death. You would not like to see the Jackal God play favorites? Think what you are doing. All over the world there is birth, but no death. Our planet cannot support so many lives at once.
Your housekeeping doesn't concern me, Zazu. It's your record-keeping which I find atrocious. your official tally of the number of animals in the jungle is off by one.
From Karachi to Botswana, they all tell the story, Bwana, of the desert where the ground is burning hot. Of the wind that cracks the stones, where the sun'll bleach your bones, and the legend there that's known as Gunga Dot.
Right. It makes no sense for freaks to fight amongst themselves. A dragon is more valuable to us alive. It's just a matter of enabling him to realize his freak blood runs deeper than his police blood. Should be an engrossing drama to see played out, wouldn't you say, Lieutenant Darling?
This is a mistake, Lord Dragornis. If we do not use the dark powers of our ancestors, I predict a dismal outcome.
What is going on? This is highly irregular. Well, actually, we're a couple of couriers, and we have a package to deliver to,
Forget it, Jarl. At least he's no dummy. She's got us figured out.
Then we must turn around right now. We cannot have a civilian with us.
Lotan destroys. He breathes, and all tools, all weaponry, all things mechanical go awry. Lotan can cause an entire culture to crumble. I have seen him blunt this spear of the hunter and splay the spoke of the charioteer. And now he has chosen your time and your city.
It had to be. Napraptor's insanity poisoned all of our minds. The Circle had failed in its sworn duties. It had to be destroyed. Nay, I will embrace it. But my death will leave one more to take, Princeling. Finish me!
Yes, these weapons you have provided will see to that. Pray tell, Mobius, what game do you play? And the news you bring, a vampire said to slay me? Where did you come upon such knowledge?
Raziel, the failed assassin. You had Cain at your mercy, but lacked the courage to fulfill the act. And now you see the wasteland wrought by the tyrant's hand. By his selfish decision to preserve his own life, even when it meant sacrificing the whole world. This is the fate of Nosgoth, as long as Cain remains alive.
And you are not his handsome Raziel anymore, his precious firstborn son turned betrayer. You have missed so many changes, little Raziel. Look around you. See how the human's weapon of destruction has become my home, indeed my body. A cocoon of brick and granite from which to watch a pupating world.
Oh, this is excellent. You know, I actually doubted my officers when they said they'd captured a prime normal. It is so nice to see you. I can't have a perfectly good prime normal and not make it one of the chosen ones, now can I? After you tell me where your vault is.
All I can tell you, Lara, is that if he persists in predicting the end of the world, it'll be the end, all right, of his political and professional career.
But what if he's right, Father?
Try convincing the Council. He hasn't one support of his theory. They even avoid him in the hallways, and do you know why?
Why's that, Solvan?
Because you can never be wrong, Jor-El. You can never let it go. You have an ego the size of Argos.
Why, yes, it is. Young Enzo Matrix, home from the games. My, how you've grown. And such toys. Does your sister know you're playing with them? Where is that annoying chatter of yours? Mega breath this and mega bath that. Why don't you put that gun away, boy, and try fighting like a real sprite? Yes, well, be that as it may. Why is that old mouse butting in? Who is he to say what's right and wrong? He may be spineless, but he got what he wanted out of you. And that makes him a troublemaker.
Looking for something?
Well, I'm pleased to inform you that the pig has been captured.
Captured?
Yes, and taken to Fort Posero. The fight is over. We won. And precisely at sundown, we will roast and eat our spoils, namely your pig.
What do you mean, roast a pig?
Read the charter, Yankee.
Well, in my third book, Taming Your Toddler, 1995 from Las Vegas University Press, I explained that the infant should be lifted by his waist, not his armpits.
Here's your bib, Chucky.
Careful. I'm sure you realize that tying the bib is a highly symbolic act. If you tie too tightly, you deprive the child of his emotional freedom.
Oh, my.
But tie too loosely, and you deny him the firmness of your love.
Yikes!
Either way, the damage could be irreparable.
The great merchant ships with their cargoes of Arcturian solar crystals felt safe and secure. Little did they suspect that they were pursued by pirates. And the most feared of all these pirates was the notorious Captain Nathaniel Flint.
Early in my exploration of this planet, it became clear to me that the behavior of these Erdlufi was a threat to Tyrosian culture.
Drakkar, your mission was to make friendship, trade.
It didn't work that way. Earth is a warlike planet with weapons of mass destruction, most of which are in this place called America. The only thing Americans respect is superior force. We will use this base to support such a force.
Dr. Benedict, we're ready for the test.
Coming.
Ready?
I've been ready for decades. Just do it!
Yes, sir. Initiate photon channeling. Set magnification coordinates 0.073. Engage tractor beam now.
Long ago, on a small blue planet called Earth, there was a young alien girl who lived in a tea. She had many friends. She was very powerful and very brave. And although she never thought much of it, she was also very beautiful. Her life seemed entirely perfect until one day.
Yes? He'll be second only to me in the entire realm.
But he's an old man. The job will be too much for him.
Harbon is right, sire. You need someone much younger and...
No! I need someone I can trust. Daniel, what do you say?
I will do my best, O King. I will pray to God for guidance.
Then it's settled.
Buzz, I know a little spa on Rhizome. It's a beautiful planet, completely free from conflict of any kind. How does a week of R&R sound to you?
As many traps as we laid, we'll all be rich soon, eh?
What was it?
I don't know, but whatever it is, I want it stuffed and mounted. Set up traps along the entire river. Here, here, and here. Where there's one gorilla, there must be more.
These Renaissance festival costumes get more uncomfortable every year.
Let the annoying puppet show begin. Look, could you move it along?
My kid's softball game is at 5.
But for the fractured thorax, the ruptured rostrum, and the shredded forewing, not to mention a nasty swelling in most of my ankles, I'm fine.
My dear lady, you should be primped, plumped, and pampered daily. A hard-working man such as yourself deserves the biggest piece of the pie.
I am sorry, but I beg to differ. I am a wormhole expert.
It's Dr. Werner von Braun, the greatest mind in the universe.
That's me. Now, if I am to believe Colin Chow from News at 4, you have two young boys here trapped in this wormhole. And you do not know what to do.
Do you think you can get them out?
It is difficult, nearly impossible, but there is one slight chance of rescue.
What's that, Doctor?
A trans-dimensional polar reversal.
Save it, Queenie. Everyone's fairer than you. This doesn't reflect well on me.
if I get my hands on you. But of course I can't, since I'm sinking in pine sap.
What's wrong, Spideris?
Isn't it obvious? I'm stuck, caught, ensnared, trapped.
You try to draw it forth? None shall touch it but me. When the time comes, I shall be the one to pull it forth. Don't ever cross me, puppet.
1,000 years have passed since the collapse of industrialized civilization. A toxic jungle now spreads, threatening the survival of the last of the human race.
Have you done as I asked, Khan? The orb must be placed within the Chamber of Ashes within the crypts. If your man fails to do this, then both of you shall answer for it.
So, advanced weapons, rocketry, chemical and biological research. Now, the occult.
Still doesn't add up.
Well, that's why we sent our boys in there.
Citizens of Earth, I am Magneto. I have 3 demands which must be met unconditionally. First, all anti-mutant programs are to be terminated immediately. Second, the island of Genosha in the Indian Ocean will be granted to me as a sovereign nation. Finally, General William Kincaid will be handed over to me for trial under mutant law. If my demands are met, the sun will shine again. If I am defied, the chill you feel now will become the endless winter of your discontent. The choice is yours.